Program is very well rehearsed, and we're going to go on the road with it when we're done here. Not. Though people have put a lot of time and energy practicing making props for this, we have not run through the whole thing altogether, so I have no idea how this is going to turn out. So be very patient with us. What I'm going to do is I will announce the act that's going to be right now, and then I'm going to say what the next act, so the next person knows that they're going to be on stage next. So there's a wide variety of staff that have participated, and we do have quite a few residents who said they wanted to do something this year. So that's very wonderful that it's across the board here, that everybody's stepping up to the plate and wanting to act a little bit unusual, let's put it that way, okay? So without further ado, our first act today is therapy.
Thank you, everybody. So I want to give a little bit of background before we start this act. This gentleman right here, his name is John. John had a stroke, a very severe stroke. And in his therapy, they found out that he likes to dance. So they incorporated dance with therapy. And it turned out to be a really fun activity, and everybody had a great time. So what we're going to do is we're going to play this video. And also on the stage is our patients and our therapist behind them, simulating how the act actually goes live. So you can see the act live, and you can also watch the video. John, in this video, breaks out into a great dance, and it's super fun, and I hope you guys enjoy. Okay, ready, Ryan? On the count of three. One. Oh, hold on. One, two, three.
Everyone's doing a great job, but that's a good job. We're going to do a dance for you. Now, we work really hard on this to do this for you.
Because you know I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Oh my God.
But I can shake it, But I'm supposed to do exactly that boom, I don't know what to say.
Oh my God.
Let's hear it for therapy. They did a great job. All right. Our next act is Who's On First. How many know this act? Who's On First? Raise your hand if you've heard it before. That's what we're doing right now. The next act up will be a white sport jacket and a pink carnation. So if you're that act, you're on deck. Okay? But before we start this Who's On First, I kind of need to see if they're ready in the back. Anyway, are you guys ready, Keith? Okay. See? see what I mean about being well rehearsed? Okay, he forgot his script, so we'll give him that. All right, but before this act start, we have audience participation. And how many know the words to take me out to the ball game? Yes, 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 raise your hand. Okay, so we have to sing before they'll start their act. So are we ready? Here we go. Take me out. Take buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back. Let us root, root, root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame. For it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game. All right, take it away.
Testing, testing.
Okay, can you hear me? Uh-oh.
Are you on?
Yep.
Okay. All right.
One.
Okay. There we go.
Hang on, let's point this up. Is that better? Okay. Okay, listen. I've been asked to set up a baseball team for Masonic Pathways residents. So here's the problem. I've been here 20 years in this country, and I've never, ever played. Tell me what you know.
Well, strange as it may seem, they give ball players nowadays very peculiar names.
Oh, I know I give those ball players awful funny names. You know the guys' names?
I sure do.
Then tell me the guys' names.
I say, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third, and you?
You the manager?
Sure.
You know the guys' names?
I'm telling you the guys' names.
Well, who's on first?
Yes.
Go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I'm asking you.
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you.
You ain't telling me nothing. I'm asking you, who's on first?
That's it.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first base.
That's his name.
Who?
That's...
Oh, yes, that's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I'm asking you, who's on first?
That's it.
Then go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
That's it.
What's the guy's name on first?
No, what's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
That's what I'm asking you. Who's on first?
Now, wait a minute. Don't go changing the players.
I'm not changing nobody. I asked you a simple question. What's the guy's name on first base?
What's the guy's name on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's on third. Now, we're not talking about him.
Look, you've got a first baseman.
Yes.
Then tell me the fella's name playing first.
Who?
The guy playing first.
That's his name.
Wait, that's the guy's name on first base.
What is the guy's name on second base?
Who's playing second?
Who's playing first?
I don't know.
He's on third base.
Look, when you pay the first baseman every month, what do you pay the money? Who do you pay the money to?
Every dollar of it.
Yeah, look, you've got to pay the money to somebody on first base, don't you?
Yes.
Don't you give him a receipt?
Sure.
How does he sign the receipt?
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
That's how he signs it.
That's how who signs it?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
When you give the guy the money, does he have to sign the receipt?
He does.
Well, how does he sign his name?
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
That's how he signs it.
You just don't give money to someone without having them sign the receipt.
No, who signs it?
What are you asking me for?
Now, calm down. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you that...
Well, go ahead and tell me. What's the guy's name that signs the receipt on first base?
Well, now, wait a minute. What signs his own receipt?
Who signs his own receipt?
No, who signs his?
I'm asking you, when the guy on first base gives you that piece of paper...
Yes, now wait.
He puts his name on it?
No, who puts his name on it?
How?
And what puts his name on it?
And how does the fella's name on first base look to you when he signs his name?
Who?
To you.
That's how it does.
How does it look to you?
Who?
To you.
Who?
To you.
Who? Look.
When the guy signs his name, how does it look to you?
Now that's how it looks. Who?
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 I'm asking you, what's the guy's name on first base you give the money to?
Who? After all, isn't the man entitled to?
Who is?
Yes, sometimes even his wife comes down and collects it.
Whose wife?
Yeah, sure.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base?
What is on second base?
I'm not asking you on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's...
Third base, I know.
Yes.
You've got an outfield.
Sure.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask you.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
Because...
Oh, he's center field.
Oh.
Told you, all these players got very...
All I'm trying to figure out is what's the guy's name in left field.
Now, what's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
You got a pitcher on this team?
Wouldn't be a fine team without a pitcher.
What's his name?
Tomorrow.
You don't want to tell me today?
I'm telling you.
Then go ahead.
Tomorrow.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
Now listen, who is not...
I'll break your arm. You say who's on first. I want to know, what's the pitcher's name?
What's on second?
I don't know.
Third base.
You got a catcher?
Sure.
The catcher's name?
Today.
You don't want to tell me today. Tomorrow, do you?
No, I'm telling you.
So what's the catcher's name?
Today.
Today and tomorrow's pitching.
Now you've got it.
Now I've got it?
Yes.
Hey, all we got is a couple of days on the team.
Well, I can't help that.
All right, you know now, I'm a good catcher. Now, I got behind the plate and tomorrow's pitching on my team and the heavy hitter gets up.
Yes.
Now, when he gets up, me being a good catcher, I'm going to throw the guy out at first base. So the guy bunts the ball, I pick up the ball, I'm going to throw the guy out to first base. So I pick up the ball and throw it to whom?
Now that's the first thing you've said right today.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's all you have.
That's all I have to do is throw the ball to first base. Now who's got it?
Naturally, now you've got it.
I throw the ball to first base, somebody's got to get the ball. Now who's got it?
Naturally.
Who?
Naturally.
Naturally?
Naturally.
So I pick up the ball and I throw it to naturally.
No.
He gets the ball, naturally gets the ball, and that...
No, you throw the ball to first base.
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
So I pick up the ball and I throw it to naturally.
No.
Naturally gets the ball and
you
and
throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
You're not saying it.
I said I throw the ball to naturally.
No, you don't.
I throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
No, it isn't.
I throw the ball to first base. Somebody's got to get it.
So, who gets it?
Naturally.
That's it.
Okay, now I ask you, who gets it?
Naturally.
Same as you.
Now listen.
I throw the ball to naturally.
You throw the ball to who?
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
He better get it, so I throw the ball to first base.
All right.
Whoever gets it drops the ball and the guy runs to second. Now, who picks up the ball and drops it to what? Who throws it to I don't know? I don't know throws it back to tomorrow, triple play.
Could be.
Another guy gets up and hits a long fly ball to because.
Yes.
Why, I don't know. He's on third and I don't give a darn.
What'd you say?
I said I don't give a darn.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
So if I say, who's on first, what do you say? Naturally, thank you. All right, our next act is our staff member, Susan Bogart, and she is doing a rendition to a white sport jacket and a pink carnation. Then our next act is Layla and Carly's Magic Show. All right, are you ready? All right, go ahead.
Sport coat and a pink car. I got one more. Here you go. You're welcome. Oh, I'm out of here.
Thank you so much. All right, our next act is the Layla and Carly Magic Show. And on deck is the activities who is doing the makeup tips with Wanda.
We'll start over. This is Layla. Can you say hello?
Hello.
And this is Carly.
Hello.
And they are magic. And so they asked if we would help and throw the sheet up so that they can disappear. So will you do that? Are you ready? I count three. One. Two. Rita, to the stage. Rita.
Hello, hello.
Are you ready? Okay, wait. All right. Last year, Wanda was here last year, but she did cooking with Wanda last year. But now, this year, she's doing makeup tips with Wanda. This is
You're going to take
this is our life enrichment from nursing. Enjoy.
Hey, Lisa, she needs the microphone.
Really, I don't think I do. I'm loud enough.
That's true.
I may really believe I need a microphone, I mean. Today we have our cookbook, Wanda.
Hello, everybody. Hello. I am Wanda. You may remember me from last year from our wonderful Sunday we had. Today I would like to show you how to do a beautiful makeup for the end of the night to make see how beautiful my face is. It doesn't happen on its own. I have to be beautiful from overnight. So I'm going to show you some tips. You don't have to use food just to eat. You can use it to make yourself beautiful as well. So first I'm going to take off my glasses because it's hard to put on the makeup with the glasses on. Oh, thank God. Oh, okay. And first you have to start with a base. I suggest a butter stick that you let stay slightly warm. You have to take off. You stick it in the sugar. Just stick it right in the sugar. You got to stick it. There we go. Mishy, mishy. Get all that sugar all mixed up in there, it's so nice. You want to make sure that it's very well covered because that's going to scrub all that dead, icky skin off your face. Okay, so we just put it on the face. Make sure you scrub it in all nice. It's so nice and smooth. Oh, it's beautiful. Make sure you get it in there very good. Oh, it's so nice. Okay, we're going to stop now. Next, we put on the whisk. We need the whisk. The whisk needs to take it. The whisk will help you smooth it around your face. Whisk it. There we go. Look how, oh, be careful, though, not to smack yourself in the face. And watch your nose. Always watch your nose. It gets stuck in the whisk. It hurts. Don't do it. Okay, we can stop with the whisk. Okay, so next we need to put on the flour. It makes a nice base. Oh, we have to wipe our hands first to get the butter off. Okay, thank you so much, Miss Rita. You're so nice.
De nada. Okay,
we stick it down. We're puffy puff. Puff. Try not to get it in your eyes. Or your mouth. It tastes terrible. And your eyes
are so blind. Wait a minute. You missed the forehead.
Oh, I missed the forehead. I so thank you so much. Oh, it's so nice. Okay, we're good. I like it. Okay, try not to get it in your hair. It'll never come out. Wipe your hands. You wipe it. So next we need to get the whipped cream because...
No,
I almost forgot. We have to roll out the wrinkles. You need your rolling pin. This is important. Now be gentle with the rolling pin. Because if you hit yourself too hard, it will hurt a lot. Or you may wake up tomorrow with a concussion. So you roll it out gently. Gently roll, ever so nicely. Okay. Oh, if we feel that tomorrow. Okay. Would you mind taking the... We have to put it... Oh, but wait! We get our empty tin. Oh, thank you, so nice. I had my hands full. And we spray the whipped cream into a tin. Just a minute.
Would you like me to help you?
Could you? There we go. Oh, I got it. Thank you. Shake it up. Make sure you shake it up. It's good to shake it up. And you just keep going. Get it off in there. You want to get lots and lots because you don't want to miss any spots. You take it, and you don't have to spread it around. You literally just take it, and you just put it right on your face. But if you're not careful, you'll get it in your eyes. And then you just go and say, oh, yes, it doesn't matter, I can't see. So when you wake up in the morning, you look like this. You're so beautiful. I thank you so much for having me. You have a good day.
Thank you, Wanda. Very good.
I don't have nothing. Use this. Okay, are we just going to move the table back?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. I don't know if I turned it off. I couldn't hear myself.
Can you help me move the table back?
All right. How many of you want her to come and do your makeup in the morning before you go out anywhere? I'm thinking that I really don't want her to, but that was very funny. Let's hear it for Life Enrichment, Nursing Life Enrichment. That was really funny. It's going to take a couple minutes for our next act. We have HFA, Home for the Age, our resident. His name is Harvey Clark, and he's going to sing a song for us. And as soon as he gets all set up, we'll get going here.
I think so. We'll see.
Okay. He's singing the very serious song, The Monkey That Became President.
Just a little bit of a preference to this. I worked in a bar for quite a while, so That's where I got the song. It's not me. I was there on the day Monkey came into the world. Face was round and reddish, and his hair was slightly curled. He didn't look too different from the others I had seen. Who'd have thought he was the answer to the nation's dream? At first he didn't seem to be intelligent at all. Each time he'd start to walk about, he'd stumble and he'd fall. My first impression was to be a most mistaken thought. Lord Almighty, what's this little hairy monkey wrought? Because I witnessed his departure from his mother's womb, I felt inclined to peck his progress every afternoon. One day the keeper of the coop called in the fly TV. Frankly said, I think you'll be amazed at what you see. The monkey walked and talked and made his head bowed his head. In the corner was a stack of books that he had read. An educated monkey said the papers crossed the land. It was more than weary sociologists could stand. Oh, his name was Universal, he was on the Carson show. People talked about him kindly everywhere he'd go. His insight was amazing, his philosophy was fair. Became a politician, welcomed everywhere. His wit was not to be compared with any mind intact. He'd lace a phrase with irony and blend it all with fact. Conservatives applauded and the liberals were entranced. The bigots and the integrationists were in his camp. Nobody dared to meet him in an open hot debate. He was nominated by the folks from every state. Yes, a monkey was the president, though maybe not the first. And there was peace and harmony throughout the universe. The dream I had last night has been related as it came. As for interpretation, well, it's really very plain. Would you rather have a monkey up in Washington, D.C.? Or have those people making monkeys out of you and me?
Thank you.
Thank you, Harvey. That was great. All right, our next act is called Two Old Friends.
Yeah, that's good. Hello, everybody. I'm so happy to, we are so happy to be here together on the same side, friendly even. I sure hope we get along nice since we haven't been together for a long time. I hope it's better than it was the last time. Such nonsense we went through.
Yes, it sounds good to be together again. We don't always get along, but we've been friends for years and years. So today we're going to try to be friends, except I want to tell her anything she can do, you can do. Oh, okay, I don't even know it, see? She's got to help me. Darn her, see, there she butts in again. All right, anything you can do. Where am I? Right there. That's what it said. See, she doesn't know what's going on. Didn't I say anything you can do, I can do better? I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Oh, my gosh. Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be better. Sooner or later, I'm better than you.
Oh, my gosh. No, you're not. No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can shoot a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only that?
Yes.
So can a rat.
Oh. Oh, it's your turn.
Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents?
40 cents.
30 cents?
20 cents.
Hmm.
Yes,
no,
I,
you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Well, anything you can say, I can say fast, softer.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor.
I can drink my liquor quicker than, faster than a flicker.
You know what? I can drink it quicker, and I can get sicker.
True. I can open any safe.
Where am I?
Without being caught.
I lost my place already. Anything
no.
you... Where?
I can open a safe.
I can open...
I said
you
that.
You said that.
Right.
She's always telling me what to do.
Without being caught.
Without... She said she can open a safe without being caught.
Oh, absolutely.
That's what I thought. She's a crook.
Okay.
Anything you can wear, I can wear better. In what you wear, I'd look better than you.
In my coat?
In your vest?
In my shoes?
In your hat?
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Anything you can say faster. I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. I can. I can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a sweater.
No.
Hurdle. No. Now I forgot. What?
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
I can feel it better.
Where am I?
I can do anything.
I can do most anything.
Can you bake a pie?
No.
Neither can I.
Anything? You can sing. I can sing louder. I can sing anything louder than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
That's yes, enough. I can.
Right. This is enough of that. Here we are back together, friends again, and, okay, despite our difference, we can still be friends. Can't we? Yes, we can.
Yes,
thank
we
you.
Can. Yes, we can.
All right, our next act is John Corey. Where are you? All right, he's on his way up. He is going to be singing a song. It's a surprise to me because I don't know what he's singing. So enjoy the music of John Corey. What? Just a second. I forgot to bring my script up here. All right, on deck will be Bob Knight. You're going to be after John, okay? And then Jane Peters, you're after him.
You want me to bring it back to the beginning?
Okay.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Here comes Mr. John.
I feel so unsure. As I take your hand and lead you to the dance floor, as the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind the silver screen and all its sad goodbyes. Never gonna dance again, get defeated, got no rhythm, no, it's easy to pretend. No, you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. It's the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Uh-huh. time can never mend. The careless whispers of a good friend to the heart and mind. Ignorance is kind. There's no comfort in the truth. Pain is all you'll find. I'm never gonna dance again. Get deep, beat, got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. I should've known better than see the friend. I wasted time that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again. The way I dance with you. Don't you love? Tonight the music feels so long. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Maybe it's better this way. We hit each other with the thing we wanted to say. We should have been so good together. We could have did this dance forever. But now I'm gonna dance with me. Please stay. And I'm never gonna dance again. Get these feet have got no rhythm. Oh, it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than the cheated friend. I wasted the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Ha ha.
Let's hear it for John Corey. Nice job, John. Okay, our next act is HFA resident, Bob Knight, and he's reciting a poem. But he's known this poem, he's telling me yesterday, since he was 4 years old, so I'm pretty impressed.
Well, let me tell you how I learned it when I was 4 years old. My sister was 3 years older than me, and this is what I kept hearing from her. Say, I got a baby brother. I never teased to have another, but he's here. They just went ahead and bought him, and then last week the doctor brought him. Isn't that queer? When I first heard the news from Molly, of course I thought it jolly, 'cause you see, I thought they'd let me play with him. But when I saw him, I said, is that him? Is that Mike? They said yes, and ain't he cunning, and I thought they must be funnin'. He's a sight. He won't sit up. You can't arrange him. I don't know why Pa don't change him at the store. Now we gotta dress and feed him, and we really didn't need him any more than a frog. Why'd they buy me a baby brother? when they knew I'd really rather have a dog.
Thanks, Bob. We also have another reading, and this is by Jane Peters, and she lives out in the Village Estates. She has a reading for us.
Carpool.
This is a saying by Don McMillan. Actually, it's a children's book that came out 4 or 5 years ago, and I just happened to run across it, and it fit. I need a new butt. Mine's got a crack. I can see in the mirror. I looked in the back. Did I do it on the slide or the banister inside? Or when I jumped my BMX? Or with the fart that happened next? Of course, the fart. That's what blew my butt apart. It spit the thing clean in two. Now I wonder what to do. I need a new one. A green one or a blue one, a fat one or a thin one, a wood one or a tin one. Why not an arty farty butt? One to not be forgotten, with watercolors on the top and a mural on the bottom. Or yellow spotted, purple dotted, a butt with color. A butt with flair, a butt as bright as I dare to wear. A butt as bright as Dad's underwear. Or maybe an alien's butt, made from a metal from titanium. Fireproof, bulletproof, bombproof. I'd like a butt that's safety rated. The right butt, a knight's butt, a butt that's armor plated. What about a bumper butt? Chrome or not, I say, from a 1960 sport coupe, one made in the USA. With accessories to complement, like strips of silver smoothly bent. A set of lights, left and right, for backing up in the night. With the bumper butt, I won't be scared, because bumper butts can be repaired. But a bumper butt is huge. A bumper butt weighs a ton. I've changed my mind. I want a lighter one. A rocket butt, all fire and thrust, a robo butt. Now that butt's a must. No, I think it's all too late. This cracked butt is just my fate. I'm here on my own in this cracked butt zone. No one to care, no one to share. Wait, what's that I hear? This is outrageous. Are butt cracks contagious? Dad, your butt crack is showing. And Dad, there's no way of knowing just how far it's going. Finding out your butt is broken is sort of a worry. But think of the possibilities for a new one. The end.
That was hilarious.
Thank you very much, Jane. Our next act is the ABU unit. They have practiced a lot. They've spent a long time on their props, so they've done a great job. So they, and it's gonna take them a couple minutes to get set up because there's this, a lot to do. They have to bring their props up a little bit. So what they're going to do is, it is like a road trip for the Masonic Home Bus, and it's called Carpool Karaoke. So they want you to sing along if you know the songs. Some of them you will know. They were all on television at one time, some in the 60s. I'm not sure if they were in the 50s, but definitely 60s and the 70s, and I think there was a couple in the 80s. So if you know the songs, sing along with them and give them just a couple minutes to get set up.
Thank you.
stairs. Hold on. Okay, we gotta go. It's quite a ways to the store, so. Whew. Okay.
Can we get some music?
What are you gonna say?
Let's let Tanya catch her breath first.
Okay. I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Oh, let's go. Oh,
thank goodness.
Whew. Hold on a second. Can you turn the air on? It's hot in here. Oh, that's right. Everybody's cold. Everybody, I'll just be okay. Are you kidding me?
Traffic jam.
What?
What should we do?
What is this, a construction zone? In October? Oh, okay. All right. Man. Ladies, traffic's backed up for a long time. We gotta do something.
Why don't I turn on the radio?
Yeah, what kind of, you got good stations up there?
Let's see what's on.
All right.
Channel 4.
Tales of a fateful trip that started from this tropic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailor man, the skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour. A 3-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the middle would be lost. The middle would be lost. The ship set ground on the shore of this uncharted desert island with Gilligan, the skipper too, a millionaire and his wife, a movie star, the professor Marianne, here on Gilligan's Isle.
Oh, that's a pretty good radio station. I like that one. You know, they play the same song over and over. Over again. This is good. I like this one. What number is this one, Melissa?
This is XM Show Tunes.
XM Show Tunes. What else they got? What's coming up next?
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
What do you think?
Here's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold like their mother. The youngest one in curls.
Dancing in your chair, won't it? I was bouncing.
Do you want to keep listening to the station?
Let me check on the track. Yeah, we better.
Okay.
Oh man, I hope it's a good one. I hope I know this one. Do I know this one? You think I know this one? Mm-hmm. Well, if you know it, sing loud. Because I don't, you gotta teach me the words and stuff. That's what we need to do. Okay? If you know this one, Tina, make sure you sing it loud, because I don't really know all of the words to some of these songs. If they play on the radio.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, Schlemiel.
This is a good song.
Hydrograph Incorporated.
come true. I love it.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a pal and a confidant.
Our traffic jam. All right, for our very last act today, we put them last because they're full of zip and vinegar. I want to introduce, last but not least, the Nursing Life Enrichment Department. They're the Lady Pillow Dancers.
Okay, you guys ready?
I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? Fit out and been for Cotton Eye Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
Can I'm shuffling.
For the Life Enrichment from Nursing, or the Lady Pillow Dancers. Give them a round of applause. All right. This was our last act today. I appreciate from the bottom of my heart for those that said they would do an act. We never know from year to year what it's going to look like, so it's always nice when people step up to the plate. It's hard work. They have to practice and think up stuff to do, so I thank them. Thanks to you guys for dressing up. Thanks for the staff for dressing up, and I wish from the bottom of our hearts, happy Halloween to all of you, and we'll see you next year. Happy Halloween, everybody.